And what are these, Paul? Asked Evelyn, opening a tarnished gold box and examining its contents curiously.
Seeds of some unknown Egyptian plant, replied Forsyth, with a sudden shadow on his dark face, as he looked down at the three scarlet grains lying in the white hand lifted to him.
Where did you get them? Asked the girl.
That is a weird story, which will only haunt you if I tell it, said Forsyth, with an absent expression that strongly excited the girl's curiosity.
Please tell it. I like weird tales, and they never trouble me. Oh, do tell it. Your stories are always so interesting, she cried, looking up with such a pretty blending of entreaty and command in her charming face that refusal was impossible.
You'll be sorry for it, and so shall I, perhaps. I warn you beforehand that harm is foretold to the possessor of those mysterious seeds, said Forsyth, smiling, even while he knit his black brows and regarded the blooming creature before him with a fond yet foreboding glance.
Tell on. I'm not afraid of these pretty atoms, she answered, with an impetuous nod.
To hear is to obey. Let me read the facts, and then I will begin, returned Forsyth, pacing to and fro with the far-off look of one who turns the pages of the past.
Evelyn watched him a moment, and then returned to her work, or play, rather, for the task seemed well suited to the vivacious little creature, half child, half woman.
While in Egypt, commenced Forsyth slowly, I went one day with my guide and Professor Niles to explore the Cheops. Niles had a mania for antiquities of all sorts, and forgot time, danger, and fatigue in the ardor of his pursuit. We rummaged up and down the narrow passages, half choked with dust and close air, reading inscriptions on the walls, stumbling over shattered mummy cases, or coming face to face with some shriveled specimen perched like a hobgoblin on the little shelves where the dead used to be stowed away for ages. I was desperately tired after a few hours of it and begged the professor to return. But he was bent on exploring certain places and would not desist. We had but one guide, so I was forced to stay. But Jamal, my man, seeing how weary I was, proposed to us to rest in one of the larger passages, while he went to procure another guide for Niles. We consented, and assuring us that we were perfectly safe if we did not quit the spot, Jamal left us, promising to return speedily. The professor sat down to take notes of his researches, and stretching myself on the soft sand, I fell asleep. I was roused by that indescribable thrill which instinctively warns us of danger, and springing up, I found myself alone. One torch burned faintly where Jamal had struck it, but Niles and the other light were gone. A dreadful sense of loneliness oppressed me for a moment. Then I collected myself and looked well about me. A bit of paper was pinned to my hat, which lay near me, and on it, in the professor's writing, were these words.
I've gone back a little to refresh my memory on certain points. Don't follow me till Jamal comes. I can find my way back to you, for I have a clue. Sleep well, and dream gloriously of the pharaohs.
I laughed at first over the old enthusiast, then felt anxious, then restless, and finally resolved to follow him, for I discovered a strong cord fastened to a fallen stone, and knew that this was the clue he spoke of. Leaving a line for Jamal, I took my torch and retraced my steps, following the cord along the winding ways. I often shouted, but received no reply, and pressed on, hoping at each turn to see the old man poring over some musty relic of antiquity. Suddenly the cord ended, and lowering my torch, I saw that the footsteps had gone on. Rash fellow! He'll lose himself to a certainty, I thought, really alarmed now. As I paused, a faint call reached me, and I answered it, waited, shouted again, and a still fainter echo replied. Niles was evidently going on, misled by the reverberations of the low passages. No time was to be lost, and forgetting myself, I stuck my torch in the deep sand to guide me back to the clue, and ran down.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.